Kama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Kitaffe tukwebaza nate nti oli mulungi.
Thank you that you are good.
Weebale olw'ekisa kino ky'otuwadde.
Thank you for this grace that you've granted us.
Okunoonya amaaso go.
To seek your face.
Nga tumanyidde ddala.
Knowing very well.
Nti ababanyiikira okunoonya bakulaba.
That they that diligently seek you find you.
Tuli wano nga tunoonya amaaso go.
We are here seeking for your face.
Era twebaza ebigambo by'ogenze oyogera naffe.
And we thank you for the words that you've continually spoken to us.
Kaakano tukwaniriza.
Even now we welcome you. That you will continue to speak to us. What we need is your love. There is nothing better than your love. When you receive your love, all other things will work out themselves. We have come, want to be in love with you. We have not come as a routine, but we have come for that love. Holy Spirit, welcome you in our midst.
Kusinge birala byona kubanga sirina yo mulala hayinzo kunjagalanga hatera
sirina yo mulala
hayinzo
kungumikiriza
se
kumusalaba bwe wafawa biko kusobya kwange Sirina chenyizo kusasula Wabulo kwa gala choka Sirina chenyizo kusasula Wabulo kwa gala
Chagalan kwa gale
Chagalan kwa gale Kukusinge virala viona Kubanga sirina yomulala Tongue is the cause of the
You need to love God more than any other thing. Because no one else can love you like Jesus. He's not there. Love God more than any other thing. Praise the Lord. Those are his names. I'm happy to be here. And I thank my bosses, Bishop and the entire committee, for permitting me to be here. Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazwe.
Praise the Lord.
Nebaza mukama anti ampo budde kakati obunji ko ku mulimu.
I thank the Lord because he now gives me much more time at my place of work.
Baba garment ndi engineer mu umeme.
They told you that I'm an engineer in umeme.
Okusoka nalinga nkola ku districts.
First of all, I used to work at the district level. So I would be the in charge of all the district meters.
Nayenga omulimu gubera ku gwabunkenke nyo.
And I would be so much on pressure. You had to be there every time. And sometimes they would call me a mid-service. And they tell me there are the things that you alone need to be here to solve. So that would hurt me so much. And I told the Lord that God hold me with a job with which I will serve you more than this. And much more time with you. And I tried in my own wisdom, but it got stuck somewhere. We would wait for the human resource to issue the names, that I may be changed to another station. I tried to follow it up so much, but it refused. But because I had told God that I want this because of my time and you, after 3 years,
human resource nyine yankubira.
As I was there, the human resource called me.
Nyamangamba nti abasi senior management team batude.
And he told me that the senior management team sat.
Aba bakama baffe ne bakusaba.
And our bosses
requested that
you may be changed to another section. They request you to join the team that teaches engineers. But they asked me, do you buy it or you don't need it? So I got a promotion.
But
its motive behind it was for me to get time for God. And now the section that I'm in, we make the program for the entire year at the start of January. And I already know what we'll do in November. And so I get enough time with God and to serve the Lord. Praise the Lord. So I testify that it is his time. God saw that yearning in me for my relationship with him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We are here to seek the Lord. And in 12 days, we are seeking the Lord. Seeking the face of the Lord through prayer and fasting. And we have been fasting for the past time. I avoid so much to do things on routine. I always want to do something and it comes out effective. When it has profit in it. When it has things that can be seen. When you don't just do it as a routine that I've come to
complete,
but when there are things that someone can see. Therefore, if we are seeking the Lord, if we are in prayer and fasting, are we doing the right motive? are the motives behind what we are doing, the ones that are clearly mentioned in the Bible? Are they the ones that God is interested in? Are you sure that that's what exactly God is interested in? That if he says, seek me, are you sure that what is in your list are not contradicting with his aims and objectives? Otherwise, you will repeatedly do it and yet have no product. And at the end of it all, you are discouraged. Because every time you do something that out of it does not come your expectations, you become discouraged.
You get frustrated.
You get frustrated. And so many people have been frustrated by the things of God. Because we have not done them as he ordered them to be done. And we have not taken trouble to understand how does he want them to be done. You come in prayer.
Obo sinza mukama.
Are we worshiping the Lord?
Obo gabira abantu.
Or giving to people.
Obo wayo mukanisa.
Or giving in church.
Chona chokola.
Whatever you do.
Nayo chikolanga yebo yagala chikolebwe.
But are you doing it the way he ought it to be done? Now, for us, when we are doing something in engineering, you care so much to see that you do whatever you do the way it is supposed to be done. Because if you don't do it the way the one who manufactured it wants it to be done, you'll have very negative outcomes. Therefore, as we seek the face of the Lord, which motives do you have? As we are in prayer and fasting, what are those things on your list? When God was creating a person, he created him that he may have a relationship with him. And the first man, our Adam, who was the first man, they first put for him things. They put a garden for him. And God brought him at the scene. And the Bible tells us
God used to come in the cool of the day to speak to him.
Tikatonda yajanga kumacha okogera naye.
But in the Bible says in the cool of the day.
Yajanga mu kiseera ekyempewo kwogerako naye.
He could look out for man.
Nga anoonya omuntu.
Says, where are you?
Ng'agamba oli ludda
wa. I want us to talk.
Njagala tuwogeremu.
I want us to have a chat.
Njagala tubeko bya tunyumyamu.
How are things going?
Ebintu bitambula bitya?
He could come.
Yajanga.
In the cool of the day.
Mu kiseera ekyempewo.
To chat with him.
Okwogerako naye.
To have a relationship with him.
Okubeerako n'enkolagana gy'abeera naye.
Until one day.
When
he came in that cool of the day
and he found
that things were not the same
anymore, he could
call out to his friend.
He could come
and he couldn't see him.
He says,
where are
you?
I've come as
usual. I
want us to talk.
Where are
you, my friend?
Oli wa mukwano gwange.
And Adam was hiding.
Adam yekwese.
This time Adam couldn't face God.
Omulundi gunogo kanga Adam tasobola kusinkana Katonda.
Adam was hiding somewhere.
Adam yali ayinawe yekwese.
Where are you?
Nenga abuzo oli ludda wa.
It was relationship.
Yali nkolagana.
And Adam had to speak from wherever he was hiding.
Kati Adam ngaino kogerereyo yali yekwese.
I say I cannot come to you.
Nagamba sikyasobola kujja gyoli.
I'm somewhere. There's somewhere where I am.
Nina wendi.
I'm hiding somewhere.
Nina wene kwese.
I cannot come to our place.
Sisobola kujja mu kifo kyaffe
kyetusisinkanira. What has happened?
Chechiriwo.
Why can't you come?
Lwaki tosobola kujja?
Says, I cannot come.
Agamba nedda sisobola kujja.
There was no more facing God.
Nga takyasobola kusisinkana
Katonda. The relationship was gone.
Enkolagana ng'egenze.
It had gone sour.
Ng'einaje egenze.
And God told Adam.
Katonda n'agamba Adam.
Have you done what I told you not to do?
Okoze ekyo kye nakugaana okukola.
Adam mentioned the statement.
Adam n'akola statement.
And said, I'm this way naked.
N'agamba ndi eno ndi bwerere.
Who told you that you are naked?
Katonda n'amubuuza ne yakugamba nti oli
bwerere. Have you done what I told you not to do?
Okoze ekyo kye nakugaana okukola.
And the relationship had gone sour.
Enkolagana ng'ekaaye.
And at one point,
era mu kiseera kimu,
God had to part ways with Adam.
Katonda yali alina okwawukana ne Adam.
And Adam was taken out of the garden.
Adam n'aggyibwa mu lusuku.
And they put cherubims to guard the garden.
Ne bateekawo bakerubi bakuuma olusuku.
And God did stop there.
Era Katonda teyakoma awo.
He remained looking to restore that relationship.
Yasigalanga anoonya engeri gy'azzaawo enkolagana
eyo. Because of the love he has for us.
Olw'okwagala kwalina
gye tuli. He remained reaching out to man.
Yasigalanga akyatuuka eri omuntu.
Although my friend is out of the garden.
Newankubadde nga mukwano gwange afulumye.
But I'm still looking after him.
Naye era nkyamunoonya.
I want to restore that relationship.
Njagala kuzzaawo enkolagana eyo.
And God had to send prophets.
Katonda ng'alina okutuma bannabbi.
God had to send various people.
Nga Katonda alina okutuma abantu
ab'enjawulo. God looked for ways of restoring the relationship.
Ng'anoonya engeri gy'azzaawo enkolagana eno.
He was caring for his friend.
Yali nga afaayo eri mukwano gwe.
Until all the prophets came.
Mpaka bannabbi bonna bwe bajja.
He tried to make a way of atoning sins once a year.
Nagezaako okufuna engeri gy'atangirira ekibi buli omulundi gumu omwaka.
God put there a system.
Katonda n'ateekawo
enkola. All this was gearing towards the relationship.
Bino byonna byali bigezaako kunoonya nkolagana eno eyali yabula.
Why am I going back there?
Lwaki nzira yeeyo?
Because we need to know the focus of seeking God.
Kubanga twetaaga okumanya omulamu omutuufu lwaki tunoonya Katonda.
And all the prophets came.
Era banabbi bonna ne bajja.
The Jeremiahs came.
Ba Yeremia ne bajja.
The Isaiahs came.
Ba Isaiah ne bajja.
Isaiah even spoke words.
Isaiah n'ayogera n'ebigambo.
At one time we shall have a son born unto us.
Nti olunaku olumu omwana alituzaalirwa.
And in that bringing back man.
Era mu kuzza omuntu okwo.
That's when God sent finally his own son.
Katonda ku nkomerero n'atuma omwana we yennyini.
Say, where it has reached.
N'agamba nti wano webituuse.
Send my son.
Kati nina kutuma mwana wange.
My only begotten son.
Omwana wange omu yekka.
To restore that man.
Azze obuggya omuntu oyo. Akomyewo omuntu oyo.
So in everything we do.
Kati mu buli kyonna kye tukola.
If we are worshiping God.
Bwe tubanga tusinza Katonda.
If we are fasting.
Bwe tubanga tusiiba.
If we are praying.
Bwe tubanga tusaba.
If he's interpreting,
if we are
doing ministry,
our
main thing should be the relationship with him.
Not what
we get from him. What we get from him are important. And he knows we need it. But the main focus should be relationship with him. Because when you put that right, everything is sorted.
Buli kimunga nacho kiterera. Amen.
Unfortunately,
ate chembi.
I don't know whether it's the devil or not.
Simanyo basi tano banedda.
But we've ended up
naye tumaliriza
seeking him for wrong reasons.
Nga tumunonyo lwensonge enfu.
And in Isaiah 1 it says,
era mu Isaiah sule soka agamba,
the oxen know their master.
Nti ente zimanyi bakama bazo.
The donkey knows its master.
Era n'endogo yemanyi mukama wayo.
Israel doesn't know me.
Naye Isirayiri nze temanyi.
Doesn't know me.
Temanyi.
At one point he says,
kulunako
luma agamba, who told you to come and trample my courts?
Ane yabagamba mujje mulinyirire mu lujja lwange.
Ane yabagamba, who told you?
Ane yabagamba
okulinyirira empya zange.
To come and trample over my courts.
Nejo sabato za mwene myezi.
With those Sabbath and your days of honoring the moon.
They have become a burden to me.
Ngagamba nti mufuso mugugu jendi.
Bwembalaba bifuse mugugu.
When I look at you, you have become a burden.
Now in verse 19 there in Isaiah 1,
Musule soka ye kitabo cha Isaiah mu runyiro lo 19.
That's why he says that
awagambira
abagonfu baje kulya ibara byensi.
That the humble and obedient will eat the fruit of the land.
In 19 and 20,
Mulinyolo 19 no 20,
there are certain things before eating the land.
Nate waliwo ebintu ebisokeraka nga tonaba kutandika kulya nsi.
Nga tonda tukakulunyirirwa okulya ensi.
Before you come to the verse of eating the fruit of the land,
byatugamba.
There are some elementaries that he tells us that he wants that relationship
ekomewo.
That it may be restored. And yet for us we start from eating the fruit of the land down there. And when we are praying and fasting, there are things that we have at our list. The things of eating the land.
Verse 19.
The things of verse 19. They are the ones that we come with. And yet for him he says, before you come to 19, there are things that I am blaming you for, that Israel does not know me. Isaiah. Chapter
1.
He even gives us why, the reasons as to why we should be fasting. He says that, listen, you heaven, and incline your ear, you earth.
Isaiah 1 verse 2.
Isaiah chapter 1 verse
2.
I breastfed and nurtured.
Baba, bali mu UCC.
They are there in UCC.
Nene banjemera.
But they have disobeyed me.
Ente manya nyini yo.
The ox knows its master. And the donkey knows the place of its master. But Israel does not know me.
Abantu bange tebalowooza.
My people do not think.
Nagamba woowe gwange riri n'ebibi.
And it says, woe unto this troublesome
nation. Abantu abujjudde obutali butuukirivu.
People who have been stripped of righteousness.
Ezzadde eryabakola ebibi.
Descendants of evildoers.
Abaana aboonoona.
And son, evil children. They have forsaken their
God.
They have forsaken the righteous one of Israel. They have shifted and left him. They have turned their backs to him. And then he asks him, why do you want to continue disobeying and rebelling? Do you want to be punished more? Your entire head is sick. And your heart has been stricken. Now in this fasting, these are the issues that would bring us
first.
To build that relationship. To build that love. To see that there is love between us and him. To feel that our love is vivid. That is what should be driving us in seeking the Lord. He says in verse 11, we are still in Isaiah chapter
1.
To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me? To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me? He says the Lord. He says, I am full of the burnt offerings of rams and the fat of fed beasts. And I delight not in the blood of the bullocks. He says, when you come to appear before me in verse 12, who has required this at your hand to tread my coats? I am traversing them speedily. Bring no more vain oblations. Incense is an abomination unto me. The new moons and Sabbath, the calling of assemblies. Listen to verse 15. And when ye spread forth your hands, I will hide mine eyes from you. You make powerful fiery prayers. But if you have not paid attention to the elementary, if you have not paid attention to the relationship, your love with him, he says, I will hide my eyes from you. And listen to the next
verse 15. When
you make many prayers, I will not hear.
One of another.
That's why you see we are always in prayers year after year. Praying and fasting always. And yet he has already told you. If you don't work upon the other ones, the things of relationship, however much you pray, I will not always hear. Do you know how many of our prayers are hitting walls? And we come to a point and say, God, now I have sowed this in you, please leave it out. Leave that one out. Let's leave that one. Okay.
Kubanga, we have sought God for wrong reasons.
Kubanga tunonyeza mukama olwensonga nebigendererwa
ebikyamu.
And we don't change.
There's a saying in English
waliwe njogera mu ruzungu
that only a mad man
nti omulalu yeka
does the same things
yakola ebintu byebimu
and expects a different result
chokanga asubira ebibivaamu ebyenjawulo
only a mad person
omuntu omulalu yeka
ngechitwa kola chechimu
does the same thing
inaganda bwala ochinachuka mukuluno
but he thinks that maybe it will change this time around. And comes to verse 16.
Munabe,
wash you.
Mwerongose,
make you clean.
Mujirewo dali bikolwa bya mwebibi.
Put away the evil of your doings. These would be the gifts in prayer and fasting.
Kunaba kwerongosa.
Washing and cleaning ourselves.
Hey,
doesn't he mind about the other ones? No, he minds about them. And he is going to speak about them in verse
19. First things first.
But he is still on first things first.
There is a something in English called first things first. Now we born again. We begin the Bible from back. And we always speak verse 19 so much. That if you will be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. Who are they talking about? The one who has been told what to do from back then. The man is there and he was in the bank. If he didn't obey this issue of evangelism, there are things that he cannot speak to the Lord if he has not done the other one.
Now for us, we want to twist the hand of God in prayer and fasting, telling him, you will do it. You will do it, sir.
God,
you are joking, you will do it. One week, let me add more. God, you will do it. Let me even go into dry. And you see how determined I am. God, you must do it for me. Now, if you've just gotten saved, there are things that the Lord does for a young child. They are for a young child. It's like how a young child can cry for something. At home we have two young children. One boy is 4 years old. Another one is 6 years old. But the one of 4 years cries for something. And yet it is for the other one who is 6 years old.
It is mine.
And the other one says, chino change. And we tell the one of 6 years, give it to him. Don't you see that he's young? And then he also feels like
sure.
It is his. But the other one is crying for it. Now there are things that God gives to the young ones. And they stop somewhere. And he says, now come back to the real thing. And most of us, when we had just gotten saved, there are things that the Lord would do and they
miss
you. In our craziness and incense. And for you think that is how he is. You are still young. And he says, no, leave him, he's still young. In verse 17 he says, learn to do well. Seek judgment. These are the things that we must work upon here in prayer and fasting.
Let's go to Hosea 6:6.
Let's go to Hosea chapter 6, verse 6.
We are talking about relationship with God. As we seek God in prayer and fasting, let's cultivate that relationship with Him. That intimate love with Him. Hosea 6:6 says, "For I desire steadfast love and not sacrifice." The knowledge of God rather than burnt offerings.
Okumanya Katonda, okusinga sadake zokocha. He says, "These are the things that I desire for."
Steadfast love.
Omukwano ogwaddala.
Not sacrifice.
Si sadaka.
Omanyi kuno eno sadaka jetulimu kakati.
You know that this is sacrifice that we are in.
Nebe tukole bisinga sadaka.
Even the things we are doing mostly here are sacrifice. We were in Soroti for an entire week with those in prison ministry.
And it was a sacrifice.
Eranga sadaka yenyini.
I had to leave job to go there. And to arrange with my section that I will not be around. Things are not the same when we are at missions.
Ebintu sibye bimuwe tubeere eyo ku mission.
We went to a certain
place and you'd wake up at night and it was too cold. Chisoro. Went to Chisoro and you'd wake up at night when it was too cold. And it's as if someone came and poured water on you.
But that's the normal.
The situation is not so pleasant.
It is a sacrifice.
Na yes, sadaka.
Now when a sacrifice is okoze.
You have also made some sacrifices. You also have them.
But he says, "I desire steadfast love."
Na ya gamba njaya ni rachisa.
Steadfast love.
Ni yorugande chisa.
Chisa chisa. Chisinga uku chisa. Steadfast love.
Omukwano guta chuka. That intimate love. It's what you must sacrifice for. Oh, sorry, it is more than sacrifice.
We
want to see you seeking his face. But when the motive behind you're seeking for that love, that steadfast love.
Then in verse 7 he says, "But like Adam, they transgressed the covenant.
Nayebo nga Adamu basobeze endagaano.
There they dealt faithlessly with me."
Eyo bankusiza. Eyo bankusiza.
Bankusiza. Like Adam, they transgressed the covenant.
Tinga Adamu bayonone endagaano yange. There is a covenant that you have. There is a covenant that we have with the Lord. And there are things that you have to do in that covenant.
In business language.
Mu business language. When you make a covenant with someone, there are those things we call partnership deeds.
Terms of the covenant. Terms in the agreement.
What are the things that you've agreed upon? If I'm going to do business with Alan, there are things that you must agree upon. And he must not defile them. When he defiles them,
when there's a breach of a contract, it's even taken to courts of law.
We have a covenant with Jesus. But how is it progressing? Is it progressing well on your side? Those are the things that ought to make us cry before the Lord.
There's somewhere I've dealt faithlessly with you.
That God in the sibade mwesigwa wa muna
awe. There's somewhere I've dealt treacherously.
Nina wenkoze bitali birungi maso go. But wash me with your blood. Njagala enkolagana ya fetu bis. There are things that I do and you do not delight in them. That are outside the covenant. But I have come to seek your face. Because I don't want to remain like this. That we may fall before him because of such. I don't know whether I've nullified the list that you came with. Maybe I am nullifying the list that you came with. That has your prayer requests. But good enough that
list.
This time around, let us do something that will make it pass.
Hey.
Rather than having it always in every fasting session. This time around, what we are talking about, it could be that after 3 years, you go back and say, sure, the list was not going, but now it is going forward. I have ever had a list like the one you have when I was in UK. And I was telling the Lord, God, please see through my list. For 6 years, I was telling him, please see through my list. And one time he told me, audibly, I cannot work on your list when it is like this. I was not ministering in
people.
And I was operating at a lower level in my engineering profession when I was there in UK. I was just admiring what engineers were doing. But I was saved. But Jesus would look at me. But it was not until I did extraordinary things by the grace of God. And God gave me the grace. And I began to handle my relationship with Him. I began to handle things concerning my relationship with Him. The more I dealt with my relationship with Him, and He began telling me that it is the relationship that is a priority. It's the relationship that is a priority. Now I teach engineers, I train engineers. Amen. What am I trying to say? He says in Proverbs chapter 8, verse 17 up to 20. And he says, I love those who love me. And those who diligently seek me find me. That is what he puts forward. It was wisdom speaking such. I love those who love me. And those who diligently seek me find me. And then there followed the things that always walk with me wisdom.
One of them is riches. Another one is wealth. Another one is righteousness.
And honor. Those ones I walk with them. They are just behind me. They walk with me. But first face me. I love those who love me. These ones are behind. Take off your eyes from the things behind. These ones follow me. When you love me, then they come with me. When you pull your love. These ones have to follow me. For you just say, come, wisdom,
Jangu.
Come.
Jackson.
As I draw closer to Jackson, these ones have nothing to do but to come also. And I leave them with him. And so Jesus said that if you're seeking, seek for two things. If you are here seeking the Lord, seek for two things. First of all, it's called what? It's called the kingdom. And secondly, righteousness. Oh, kingdom come. Please, kingdom come. And your righteousness come. Then you also represent the other things. Your size is enough to represent the things that you always desire. Be in line as you walk. If you're seeking, don't mind about him. That's Matthew 6. Seek the other one.
No.
And this one. This one just follows where the other ones are going.
The people
I'm telling you to seek are only two. Him and her. This one just follows where they are. All the rest. Those things on your list. All of them. They just follow these two. They follow these two. For them, they just follow these two. Now, what the church does, when you are in prayer and fasting, it says, Jesus, that thing you made a mistake. The way I want a child, now you never understood it well. These things should first go aside. Then let the child go in front.
Ogamba Yesu.
And you're telling Jesus,
I know
you misunderstood the thing very
well.
I have sought for a job for 4 years. And now you're telling me that I should first leave you. Jesus, also. Things are like this. Let this one go in front. I will also seek these ones later. And Jesus looks at you.
No.
And you look for that one. This one. This one is waiting for the other ones to move. Then the other ones wait. They're saying one thing. Okay, we know that the job is here. But the job is saying, I cannot move unless they move. Marriage is saying, you love me, yes, I see. But there are people I'm waiting for to move. If only you could tell them to move. Because they are the ones tying me here. I think how we have erred in these things. Now, for instead of calling the other one to start moving, for you are calling this one. Every fasting session you call this one. Every fasting that they declare you call this one. This one you're calling. He is waiting for the other two to move. That's why he told me that the things you're calling for are there under them. But mind about the other ones. When the other ones move, this one automatically follows. So that's where we are as the church. We say, Sir Jesus, we will also not seek for the other two. We know what we want. It is here. And every fasting, I will always call it. Every overnight, I will always call it. And Jesus says, okay, keep calling. Because this one knows, I cannot move unless the others move. All other things will only be added unto you. This is a nail that needs to land on the other magnets.
It is a magnet.
The other ones are the magnets.
Where
they are, they attract this nail. Wherever they are, they attract the nail. Wherever they are, they attract this nail. The nail is not the one that takes itself, no. There is a force that pulls it. Even if it is resisting, when you put a magnet, it has to automatically
come.
You can take your seats. Clap for the kingdom and the righteousness and all the other things.
This love for God will compel you to do certain things.
It will compel you, or it will make you listen to some songs and leave others. This love with our God, when you keep falling in it makes you abstain from some conversations. There are some movies you can no longer watch. Comedy. I was someone who loved so much comedy. But time came.
They are
always abusing. They are vulgar. So I find myself, the ones I loved so much, I feel like I can no longer fit there. And I don't need a pastor to stand there. Lubega, what are you always watching? The other love with him, it makes me no longer go there. I am someone who loves so much soccer. And when they beat Man U, I cannot even sit well. And would even send for ourselves those abusive messages. And my son is also addicted. One day we went to Chibanda to watch Man U as it was playing a final. We were playing with Chelsea. But Man U first performed badly. And my son ran crazy where he was. And he said, let them bring Nani. What is coach doing? And all the people turned and looked at the child. And one time when we were in the Chibanda, there was an Arsenal fan. I think it was a Chelsea fan. And he began abusing the supporters of Man U, not the players of Man U. And I felt like something is boiling up in me. I love so much Man U. But because of the love that I have with this one, it controls me and I don't go on one extreme. If it was not for the love with him, I would have punched the other young man. He was abusing my players.
Bagurachi.
Why did they buy that one? You take him out. And I felt like I was boiling up. And yet he was very close to me abusing my players. But my love with this one, it makes me to control myself. In this fasting, struggle that love, that relationship, if there is anything in it, and tell him, God, I want to put it right. Sometimes you may not be knowing it. David says in Psalms 19, and he says, examine me. There are those sins that are hidden, and I'm not aware of them. I might be having pride, and I'm not aware. He says, you yourself examine me. That the sin may not overcome me. And that's how righteous I will be. When it's you examining me. Now this fasting, who would be telling God to examine me? It's as if things are okay. But examine me. I want to build my love with you.
You see, when you are in an intimate relationship with a girl,
before you marry her, you even fear to stand with another girl in a dark spot. What will she say if she sees me? Okay, however much I am not conning her, but what if they see me with her? And when someone comes and finds me the other girl, and yet there is one you're going to marry, and he looks at you once and leaves, but knowing that he knows the other one that you betrothed, you must follow him. And tell him, no, we were just having a conversation. But there's nothing in much about it. You cannot just leave him to go. The love you have with the other one, you don't want anything to disorganize it. Fasting such as this, seeking the Lord such as this, it would be for us to restore our intimate relationship.
Intimate love.
The intimate love. The other things will sort themselves out. They will sort out themselves, I've told you.
eriye bintu
byende
byenga byekolako
byokka I have seen sorting themselves out
mbirabye ku kankugambe
let me tell you I have seen them
ngabwo okola ku mukwano
that when you work upon your relationship they have to work out themselves
Daudi yatuka kisana na gama no gamba
David reached a time and said that after I have perfected this love with my shepherd
ngatekawo ne meza maso
gaba he even places a table before my enemies and I sit with them He even places a table. And I sit with them, my enemies.
May
the Lord bless you, sir. They are things that I've seen sorting out themselves. Let's read from Ekitabo
ky'Oluyimba.
They are talking about issues of love. And I am the chairperson of the marriage. Katika tuogele ku Song of Songs.
Chapter 2.
Esule yokubiri.
Verse 16.
Olunyolo 16.
We are talking about effective seeking of God.
Tuogera ku kunonya mukama okutuukiridde.
Okuvaamu ebibala.
That produces fruit.
Sibino bya kujanga buzino.
Not the things of routine. Coming to fast.
Song of Songs 2 verse 16.
Kitabo ky'Oluyimba esule yokubiri olunyolo 16.
Wagambye.
It says.
My beloved is mine.
Muganzi wange, wange.
And I am his.
Nange ndi wuwe.
He grazes among the lilies.
Alisiza ekisibo kye mu malanga.
My beloved is mine.
Muganzi wange, wange.
And I am his.
Nange ndi wuwe.
When wale wale na beloved wenge Yesu.
Is there anyone here who has a beloved
that
is Jesus? Please put up your hand if you have your beloved
My
called
beloved
Jesus.
Is mine.
He says, Muganzi wange wange.
And I am his.
Era nange ndi wuwe.
Yeah.
But listen to what he says before I say what next.
My beloved is mine.
When you say that Muganzi wange wange.
You are putting a claim on him.
Oba omu wakanira.
Omai tulipa funuzi be mbuja tu sasira. Mujja tusasa tuli bavunuzi fembi oba
bango omusaba yo
putting a claim on him bajja bagana bakitegede bulungi si kumuwakanira pase but obanga lugambo oluganda lunganye nange kale
Obo olangirira nti wange
exactly ekyo kiri better ko oba olangirira nti wange
you're claiming that is mine Now here in fasting. Anything that may come between us. It has to depart.
He's mine.
And he said,
But
then the next step is very important.
And I am his.
Which says, Nange. Now this one is better than the first one. In the former one, it's you.
For him.
But in the latter one, he says, that one is mine.
Doctor Wange.
Doctor is mine.
Alan Wange.
Alan is mine.
Grace Wange.
Grace is mine.
Yesunga yayogera.
And that's Jesus speaking. In the first place, it was me who was saying that I have a beloved called Jesus. But now in the second part, he himself says, Farouk is mine. But there is something better than that again.
Chapter 7, verse 10.
It is in chapter 7, verse 10.
In Song of Songs again. This
one is better than the first two.
Chapter 7, verse 10. He says that, I am my beloved. And his desire is for me.
No kwegomba kwe kulieri nze.
Katitaka bugambi nti Farouk wange.
Now he doesn't just say that Farouk is mine.
Katonda agamba.
But God is saying
Farouk mwegomba.
I even admire him.
I am pleased with Farouk.
Musanyukira.
Okwegomba kwe kulieri nze.
His yearning is for me.
Stage ate singa kunyo.
That's now a better stage.
Omanyi bobane muchalawo.
You know if you have your wife.
Alan stuka no muchala. Ono yimuchala wa Alan. Chintu chimu,
umuchala
ono gamanti, Alan wange, nga gamba abantu.
For the other wife, for the other woman to tell people that Alan is mine.
Yogira, tesi uwo. Ngenti, Alan uli wange. Gamba naba ntutimu, Alan ono wange, gamba awasigadobo nabona. Kwa muzi indarogo ya gara mama, oba tomwe uli ya bulunji. Balika tubagambe. Kandi omusajja ono omwagala. Yogera oba omwagala.
Ono Alan wange.
Kakati ate eyo step esooka. Step eyokubiri.
The second step.
Alan kwe kugamba abantu.
Ono
ye mukyala wange.
To tell people that this is my wife.
Esingako nnyo ku ono.
And that one is better than hers.
Onebe mukolera nnyo.
It works for her so much.
Alan yagamba abantu nti wange.
When it's Alan telling people that she's mine.
Omanyeriyo okwesiba ku musajja ngo okwesa mpeta na certificate.
You know that is clinging to a man because you have a ring and a certificate. And you say it's me who got married to that man. And you see this ring? It's good. But it's better when the man says that wife is mine. But then the third step is Alan saying,
I'm proud of that woman. I'm proud of her. I'm pleased with her.
Now that one is better. And when Alan says that, and she begins to smile,
you are proud of her.
Oh, I'm proud of her. She's my wife. She's my dear wife.
Kasitobogere bigambo bwebityo kakati Yesu tusobola okumugamba nti Yesu waffe.
Now we can tell Jesus that Jesus is
Yesu
ours.
Agamba nti oyo wange.
And Jesus also says that one is mine.
Agamba nti Pastor Mukuye mwenyumiririzamu.
But when he says that I delight in Pastor Mukuye.
I will tambula mukasubi monanga nomutwe guli waguru.
You walk in Kasubi with your head high.
Yes, Katonda afa yogera ku Yesu.
God spoke about Jesus.
Babatiza Yesu.
When they were baptizing Jesus. Mwejibane
limujako.
That the dove came upon his shoulder. And he said, that is my child. In whom I'm pleased. And I love so much. Let that drive in
first. That's my worshiper.
That he may say,
I'm proud of her. That's my interpreter. I'm proud of her.
You could say that it was upon Jesus alone. But even upon Job.
Job. Have you considered my servant Job?
Oh, muddu wange Yobu omulabye.
That man, there's none like him.
Ah, teri muntu amufanana.
Nga Katonda yayogera.
It was God speaking.
Kumwe uzokoza ati oli ali Yesu tubiveko.
Because he would say other than was Jesus, but this is Job.
Have you considered my servant
Job? Oh, muddu wange Yobu
omulabye. There is none like him.
Tewali yamufanana. That one drives me every day. Because I want God to say.
Have you considered my person Rubega? I'm pleased with him. Have you considered my evangelist Mugisha?
Evangelist Mugisha wango mulabye. It's not just being in a group.
Have you considered my worshipper?
Na yomusinza wango mulabye.
Teddy.
Let that love drive us. In this fasting, let's seek for this love. It's one thing to be an instrumentalist here.
But it's another when God is proud of you. I said, among the instrumentalists, I have that man. The Bible says that for David, it wasn't mere sitting on the piano.
Teyatulanga butuzi kunanga.
When he plays that accord,
the demons would run. The demons had to run.
This was not a mere instrumentalist.
Teyali mukubi bukubi wa chuma. If I was an instrumentalist, I would be yearning for that. That I can sit on that
keyboard
and we have deliverance in church. I would be yearning for that in my fasting.
Unfortunately, we just come to minister and go.
It's as if we are on an assignment. When that girl is taking a video, it's good that I delight in her. We are, some of us are just at the level of just knowing him. Some of us, it's we who are saying he is my beloved. And then a few of them say he
He says they are his. But let's go to another level.
When I look at the pastors of UCC,
I'm
pleased with the doctor.
I am pleased in him.
I'm pleased with the pastor Mukuye.
I delight in him. When it's God speaking, if you're seeking God, build your relationship that it may mount to that. Good enough. He gave us the Holy Spirit. And he hopes us to know. What are the things that will cause Father to delight in me? The Spirit knows the things that I ought to do, that my Father in heaven will say that I boast in him. He knows that. And when we give ourselves to him, he will tell you, do not just sing the song, but just because they've called you, there is the other song. Because I have my son who's there. He came, he wanted to commit suicide. But sing this song. It will deliver him. When you sing it, the Father in heaven, he says, thank you. I boost in you. You are not just a singer, but I have loved you.
Oh, I'm pleased with you.
As we seek the Lord in the prayer and fasting, first put down the other list. Yeah, I know it's important, but first seek the relationship. First seek the love, that it may mount to a level when he delights in you. It is interesting. Let me tell you one thing as I conclude. You know, preachers, we finish four times. Now this is the second one. We have more
two.
We have more to be prepared for them. But when I just returned from UK, having determined to come back here and coming for Jesus, for the other love, I left England saying that I said I'm not doing this because I love it. I even shed tears. But I said I'm doing it for your sake, for Jesus, for the love that we have. When I reached here, he gave me a dream. When I had just arrived in my first week, and in that dream, I was in a room.
Cabinet.
It had cabinets.
Cabinet in the room, drawers.
Amen. And he told me, a voice came. And he said, thank you so much. You have well mobilized my people. You have well mobilized my people. But yet I had never stepped on any pulpit.
Remember.
Jukira. And he told me, you have well mobilized my people. And there are tickets there. They belong to you and they are taking you. They were three tickets. Now I went on opening the drawers, looking for the tickets he had told me.
Then
I searched in the first drawer. And there were my clothes. The old clothes that I used to put on. And they were folded and they were there. And the shoes that I used to put on, they were folded. And then I started to say, you see even the other shirt of mine. Yeah, you see the other shoes. Do you know, just like you can see something that you have spent 10 years without seeing. And he says, no, close that drawer. He even didn't want me to look into the old things. He said the tickets are the other side. I opened. And there were three tickets. And written on them was Rubega Fred Patrick. And the words were written in gold. And in my mind, I comprehended that there is a function or a wedding that is going to happen at Lugogo. And these tickets were the ones to take me there. And with other two people, and written on them was Rubega Fred Patrick in gold. And they were looking so good. And he told me, thank you so much for mobilizing my people. And I woke up. And I said, I've never mobilized people. Neither have I ever stepped on the pulpit to preach.
Which mobilizing is this?
Now, the other act that I did of restoring my relationship was enough to mobilize people. And in UK, some people came to know about it. And they wondered. And now I work so much, not in my own struggle, but I pray for the grace. And I say, God, let the grace be granted me. Because I saw the tickets. Because seeing them is not enough. But how will I finish the course? That drives me. And I say, God, give me the grace that I may finish well. Because I saw the tickets. I'm like Paul. I don't imagine myself having reached. But I forget the past. And I strive.
I forget the past. I forget achievements.
And I fall before the Lord. And I say, God, help me. That my tickets may remain. Call me Jesus. Sometimes even he showed me my heavenly house. Omulundi gumu, he showed me. He showed me. It was a very big house. They disturbed me. And they said, God, help me.
But
I may achieve the things that I saw. I beseech you in this fasting. I'm seeking the face of the Lord. Please. Grown in that love, that he may come to a point and say that I delight in you.
I am well pleased with you.
Remember, as we finish,
well done,
he will say that well
done, good and faithful servant.
These things, it's regardless of where you pray from. It is about your personal life.
Individuals.
They're not going to call us that UCC members now come. But one by one, stand up on your feet. As we seek the face of the Lord,
there is a better, mature level, highest degree of mature love.
Waliwo eddaala erisinga obulungi ery'okwagala.
That's the level where God says, I'm well pleased with you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says in Songs 8:7.
Bible egamba mu kitabo ky'oluyimba 8:7.
Many waters cannot quench love.
Amazzi amangi tegayinza kuzikiza kwagala.
Neither can floods drown it.
So n'ebitaba tebiyinza kukuta.
Kuno kwagala kwe tulina bwe tukuzimba.
This love that we have,
nothing
if we
can
build
take
it, there is nothing that will change you anymore. You will just be seeing things. But when you are at the level of Paul, when you say, what will alienate me from the love of Christ? Is it hunger? Is it seeing sorrow? What is that that will alienate me? When the love has mounted to that level,
and
nothing that can alienate me from his love. And that's from that we seek the Lord. Because the relationship is just built up.
Kumusalaba
bwe wafawa biko kusobya kwange sina chenyizwa kusasula wabulo kwagala choka sina chenyizwa kusasula wabulo kwagala
chakala kwagale
chakala kwagale okusinge
chiyimba ngo wulanti oyayana
kubanga sirina yo mulala aizo kunjagalanga kwe so wasirina yo mulala aizo kugumikiriza salaba chinafawa miko kusobya kwa Chenyi
Alright! Yeah.